In the market of fresh out-of-factory cafe racers, the Italjet Buccaneer 250i is definitely one of the more recognizable ones. But I was never a big fan of the way it looked. You know, I think they were trying a little bit too hard to stand out, and that led to some color combinations and design choices that I was just not a huge fan of. Now though, there's a brand new model, and on top of a couple of new features, it also comes with a refreshed look. There are two colors this year, an army green one and a Nardo grey one. And I really like the fact that they kept the color simple this time, you know, without seemingly random splashes of red or green everywhere. They also redid the exhaust, so it looks kind of like a scrambler, which fits, you know, the aesthetic of the taller handlebars and headlamp grille a little bit better. You also get bar end mirrors as standard, LED turn signals and rear brake light, as well as a set of zigzag tires on spoked wheels. Now, these tires are from a Chinese company called Timson, and the Buccaneer runs 17 inches in the front and 15 inches in the back. What I always thought was special about the Buccaneer though was its engine. This is one of the few bikes in this category to feature a 249cc air-cooled V-twin engine that makes about 18 horsepower and 19 newton meters of torque. Yeah, that's not a whole lot of power on paper, but honestly, when I was riding it, it didn't feel boring or like it needed a lot more power. It felt raw and visceral, and that soundtrack, mein Gott. There's just really something special about the way a 250cc V-twin sounds. And these are stock pipes, mind you. I can't imagine what it will sound like with just a simple aftermarket slip-on. Probably the most surprising thing to me is that the Buccaneer is actually quite practical. It has a comfortable upright riding position where your weight can be easily shifted to your legs, and when you combine that with the tall handlebar, you know, it seems like a great city bike. It can even fit two overgrown children in adult-sized bodies on its bench seat. And the little notch on the end of the seat plus the grab handles, you know, they help keep the passenger from sliding off, which is good. This year, the Buccaneer also has ABS in both the front and rear, which is nice since, you know, beginners will probably be the ones that will pick this bike up the most.
Mine is just a seat.
Whoa! Hey, that's quite a lot of space.
Can book up.
You must have iPhone.
I mean, everything is fused, it's everything here.
The Buccaneer 250i was honestly a hoot to ride, but you have to remember what kind of bike this is. It's something that's meant to look and feel like a vintage bike, so there are some drawbacks compared to modern naked, for example.
Like, if you want something just raw, man, this feels nice. You wanna try?
You know, power is definitely down over a modern naked because those make about double the horsepower for, you know, the same kind of displacement. The throttle also has a lot of play in it, which is not something I'm a big fan of. And that visceral riding experience also means you feel pretty much all of the vibrations through the handlebar, through the seat, through your foot pegs, everywhere. And while that's fun when you're blasting from cafe to cafe, if you have to go on, you know, a long commute or go out of town, it's probably going to be really tiring. But the trade-off is that for just under 19,000 ringgit on the road, you will get a bike that looks good and sounds spectacular. It's made for a certain type of rider, and you know, if you're that person, I think it's kind of hard not to fall in love with this thing. But there's only one way to find out, right? If you want to test ride a bike yourself, you can head on over to Riders Empire Motorcycles in Shah Alam, and then let me know what you think of it in the comments below. But that's it for this video. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you in the next one.
Tak deposit ke?